we've been talking about school lunches and stuff for a few weeks now, and this vindictive, evil, you know, this Mr. Seymour man who is at superhero levels of evilness. Well, research has come out in the last couple of days showing what a brilliant scheme free school lunches are on every level, including attendance, including academic response, and how it shouldn't be shrunk down, it should actually be expanded. Basically going straight to the information. We're not doing all the nice fluffy pictures of the kids having lunches. We're going to go straight into it.
And now, researchers do too.
This is about reducing barriers to education.
Auckland University's Boyd Swinburne has crunched the numbers on 21 stakeholder-determined criteria, and he found the program has exceeded expectations for more than half of them.
These free school lunches increase the mental health scores of kids in food poverty by 20%. That is a huge benefit.
Despite the data, the program could still see cuts in the upcoming budget.
The school lunch program is nearly $340 million worth of funding.
How much were those tax breaks for landlords? $2.9 billion. That means you could afford it eight times over if you weren't giving tax breaks back to landlords. See, this is something we're going to keep on keeping on, which is we're not going to allow these guys to say we can't afford this. They must say we're making a choice to get rid of it over landlords, because that's what they're doing, right? They can afford it. Like if they gave back $2 billion to landlords, they could afford it easily, right? So we're not going to let them say there's no money for that. What we're going to make them say, or say for them, is they're making a fucking choice of landlords over kids who need lunches at schools.
Labor did not set aside for any year after this year, 2024.
Seymour not budged by the findings.
I think it's important that we recognise educational outcomes. Those are the ones that the Ministry of Education tried to measure rigorously, and the evidence wasn't there.
But Swinburne says this new data does just that.
Yeah. This does actually statistically improve attendance. It's to the tune of about 3 days a school year, so it's not the totality of the attendance issue, but at least it's a significant benefit.
There's no question that we can't keep spending the same amount of money. That doesn't mean you can't.
Well, there is a question. The question involves about how much and the word landlords and given back to. That's the question, would have those words in there. So there is a question.
Can't achieve the same results.
But the researchers say instead of cutting the program, its success shows it should be expanded. And with these guys in agreement.
I think that's not fair. Every school should have heaps of lunches for everyone.
Cutting the program's funding could still prove a difficult sell. Perry Wilton, News Hub.
There you go, Joey. So, once again, we have Mr. Seymour and the right undermining, ridiculing, and not taking seriously research which doesn't suit their narrative.
Real simple. We'll keep it real simple. Why in this country should we have hungry kids? Mm-hmm. Why? I don't care if you want to get up on your soapbox and go, well, that's the parents' responsibility. Sure, there's an argument there. There's an argument why they can't. But the core question is, do we want to put up with having hungry kids in this country that produces so much food, that is a country that holds itself up to be part of the developed world? Why do we have hungry kids? Do we have the mechanism to fix it? Clearly, yes. Does it have a cost? Yes. Is that cost worth paying? My argument is, fuck yes. Anything to do with feeding people, when you scale it up, the costs, they scale with it as well. It is easier to feed people in bulk.
Yeah.
It is easy to remove barriers, remove admin. These kids are in school. What a great place. We know where they are. They're at school. Give them a lunch. You look at the countries that have amazing educational results. They get fed at school.
Yeah.
Some of the societies that we criticize manage to feed their kids at school. Why can't we do that? Why is this a new thing?
We can. The answer is we can do that. It's a choice.
We absolutely can. And it is a choice. Like every budget item they have, it is a question of choice and priority. I spoke about this pre-election, right? Is you have to work out what you want to pay for and then work out how you pay for it. Now, these guys have done that. They're telling us loud and clear, landlords, top of the pile. National level infrastructure, not as important. Feeding hungry kids, not as important. Paying teachers, paying nurses, paying police, not as important as making sure landlords have a nice, fat, healthy balance sheet.
I don't remember the exact thing that Clint said, Trevor, but one of the nights you weren't here, he basically added up all of the public servants that are service people. And he went, the armed services, the police, the nurses, the teachers, maybe there was one or two other groups in there as well. And he went, the $2.9 million could give all of them a $15,000 wage rise today. All of them. Every single one of them. $15,000 more. Nah, landlords.
Yeah. What's changed? Why have we ended up in this position? Lots have changed. And it's not a case of the last government. It's not a case of the government before that or the before that or before that. It is a snowball effect of all of these shitty choices over both of the major parties over decades.
Yeah.
They haven't kept on top of things, and you can draw a fucking straight line between where we are now and the first person going, hey, I've just read this theory called neoliberalism. We should give it a go. It has fucked our society. It has made things meaner, harder, more unpleasant to be alive since someone pulled that, I assume, out of their asshole and said it was an economic theory.
Yeah.